Thank you, Dr. Ruwais Hanifa. Ruwais, you have listened all these people over the years misguiding the innocent, gullible young medical graduates into various fields of specialties. I feel it is my duty to alleviate your suffering by introducing a truly rewarding specialty in the postgraduate education, is general medicine. Ladies and gentlemen, each society needs doctors. Each society needs different subspecies, just like needs farmers, barbers, butchers, technicians, and politicians. Each society needs radiologists, anesthesiologists, gynecologists, pediatricians, and surgeons. Without them, the field of medicine cannot sustain. However, if you feel duty bound, ladies and gentlemen, to feed the supply chain, be one of them. However, if you want to be happy, contented, and use and teach your brain, do medicine. You encounter problems, puzzles, which look daunting. Solving them gives you immense pleasure and satisfaction. I have to admit, of course, there are other ways to be happy and contented, like being a happy mother and being a happy housewife, and to have a happy mistress elsewhere. But famous, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be happy, rich and famous, do medicine. And there's a downside to each of these decisions that you make. Doing medicine is similar. You have to spend at least 5 years of youth acquiring skills that makes you a master at what you do. When you are a specialist, you will be posted far away places in the country. If you decide upon passing the MD pathway exam and choose a field, what we call the finer specialties medicine, like cardiology, gastroenterology, respiratory medicine, the lowest level of care that you can be posted is to a district general hospital, and these are situated in capital cities of each district. If you do general medicine, you can be posted to base hospitals, which are situated all over the country. These can be as close as Panagura and be far away as Mulathiu. Most of the time, you'll be 5 to 6 hours away from your house, wife, kids, and parents. There's a good and bad side to it. Bad is that you will be denied of good homemade food and a daily dose of sex. You'll miss the best formative years of your children. However, ladies and gentlemen, 1 week of physical separation also does wonders. There is a huge overcompensation when you return at the end of the week. The food will be hot, the children will be doubting, and the sex will be steamy. The gains in the form of mental and physical satisfaction and in monetary terms is huge. Ladies and gentlemen, do medicine. However, it is hard work. If you do not have it in your guts, don't do medicine. I'll not bore you with the details of entry requirements and training details. Everything is there in plain English in the PGM prospectus. However, I need to remind you about the entry requirements. You have to have an internship in medicine, general medicine, or a post-intern work experience in a medical or medical-related ward basis. You have to have 1 year post-intern. By the date that the exam, the date that you register for the exam. You have to have the certificate in advanced diploma in life, the resuscitation by the College of Anesthesiology, so the College of Emergency Physicians. And when you sit for the entry exam, which is called, popularly called the MD Part 1, you have 3 papers.
Ladies and gentlemen, just bear with us for a minute. Dr. Upul has disconnected. We are trying to get him online. Just give us a minute. So just reflect on what he said. and more importantly, how he said it. So I think Sachin from our SLMA office is trying to get Upul online. So in the meantime, please do bear with us. You're back. Okay. We can hear you. Carry on, Upul.
Yes, I'm back.
So the failures are
mainly in the basic sciences, not in the other two. So you have to polish your basic sciences, go through each component. It's well written in the prospectus. When you pass your MD part one, the training is just before you sit that. If you are intelligent and hardworking, it is not difficult to pass the exam, not because they are easy, but because the best in the generation of your generation do medicine, and they are well trained. They are trained by the best of the physicians of the previous generation. The training period after the MD part two is different. In general medicine is 2 years, and in some specialties like cardiac electrophysiology, it is longer. And but some of these years, say in the general medicine, you will be doing general medicine in a recognized hospital under a trainer who's a senior physician, and then you will have to go abroad to a recognized institution in a foreign country. The Ceylon College of Physicians helps you in each of these steps, from training courses in MD part one and part two. And during the training, the specialty updates, the guest lectures during the whole period. And it helps you to get a training post in a foreign country. The hospitals, the trusts in UK are short of staff, and our trainees are in high demand. When you go there, the living conditions are good. The question is, when you come back, ladies and gentlemen, do medicine, be a specialist in general medicine or one of its subspecialties, or return and serve your country. Thank you very much.